A2i to collect student data, and that helps us progress monitor for the most part, but also it shows us what skills our students are missing, how much help they need in specific areas. So maybe they need more help in foundational skills, maybe they need more FaceTime, teacher managed stations. But it not only helps us group our students for literacy rotations, but it also helps us when we're kind of looking down to see, okay, who do we need to recommend for tutoring? Who do we need to get in that extra help? Who should we be scaffolding for, pulling to work with the small groups during ELA? So it really is cross-curricular, which is very helpful. They're all grouped by level and by the skills that they need. We had 6 groups with about five kids in each group, and still rotating in that circle, it worked a lot better. Last quarter, we added in second grade, which kind of threw us for a curveball a little bit, because that's putting about 42 kids in a classroom with a lot of moving parts. But we were able to group them in with some of the third grade groups who are on the same levels, and we still kept that six or seven group rotation. This time around, we actually have 2 rotations happening. One's going counterclockwise, one's going clockwise. And what it looks like is there's a guided reading and a phonics station, 2 grammar stations, 2 spelling stations, and then a computer's at a game. So it feels different, but they still have extra time hitting those core skills. Rotation's a little new right now, so they're still realizing it, but that's why I have that huge chart up on the wall so they can check and say, okay, I started a guided reading, now I need to go to orange grammar because I'm in Ms. Shipper's rotation today. Essentially, each table is a station. The only station that isn't a table is our game station, which is on the carpet. The way I have it set up is there's 2 columns. One has Ms. Watson's rotation, one has my rotation. Each group has a different color nameplate with their name on it. And then according to the day, I will move it through the sheet. I use sheet protectors and whiteboard markers, and I just wrote on guided reading or phonics or grammar or et cetera. And next to it, I have the color table. So they know, because there's 2 grammar stations and there's 2 spelling stations, so that can get a little confusing if you're not sure what rotation you're in. So I just put purple table next to it or red table, and then they know, okay, that's where I need to go. My stuff's gonna be there. I can get it out. I can get started. If I were to describe A2i to a new teacher coming on board to PCA, I would say that the advantages are definitely that it gives you really good, clean data. And that's really helpful in planning for your ELA and your literacy centers. It's also a really user-friendly interface for the students, and it has ready-made lesson plans and activities that are easily incorporated into literacy rotations and that also hit on common core skills that students need.